Hi, Lisa.
Hello. Yeah. How are you?
Oh, I'm doing just great.
Good.
I'm hanging out here in my broadcast bed.
Woohoo.
In my boudoir studio.
Out of your show. I just want to tell you that.
Thank you, darling.
You've helped me get over that whole masturbation guilt shit stuff.
You didn't mean that.
Yes.
Okay. Excuse us, fathers and mothers and grandmothers and goddesses
Uncle
and gods
and uncles
at the FCC.
Okay.
So I've helped you get over what kind of stuff?
Well, the sexual hang-ups and things like that.
Oh,
just,
really?
Just that we are sexual beings, and it's a great thing, you know?
But
tonight, unfortunately, I'm calling about something else.
Ah.
I think that I'm involved with a sex addict.
Ooh.
And let me start back to last February. Been living with this gentleman. Been going out for a year, living with him 6 months. Discovered phone bills with all these wonderful numbers.
Ooh,
phone lines.
Uh-huh, I see.
At first I thought, oh, it's kind of weird, kind of destructive, not sharing it with me, you know. And then I came to the conclusion, well, he's not initiating any encounters, so to speak. And if he pays his own bill, there you go, you know. Well, you know, things, I did confront him about it, and I said, you know, we need to communicate about this. I'd be happy to do phone sex with you.
Oh, good for you.
It's wonderful. Okay, so time passed. Phone calls got, you know, were minimal. Well, then things started appearing again. I've been discovering things around the house, women's phone numbers, little four-digit extensions, wondering what are these things. Lo and behold, found the phone bill, 2 pages. Worth to a certain personal's number that I later found out.
Wow, this guy is busy.
His own mailbox set up.
Whoa!
I've heard it, and it specifically says I'm attached and looking for a discreet encounter. and I'm a little, like I said, the communication, I mean, it's so important in a relationship. I also believe, I mean, I've shared myself intimately with this person. I've been open and said, please, please, please let me join in. Hello, you know, and I just... Is this right? I'm just trying to come to an understanding and a little closure within myself and with this relationship. But
dump him.
What's that?
Oh, you know, honey, I am so sexually open and everything, and
yeah.
and one thing I believe is that sex toys,
yeah.
Okay, and phone sex is a sex toy, like a vibrator,
right,
like a dildo,
right.
like lace, like erotic videos, like books about sex, and that's what I do say in my Ten Commandments of Pleasure book. You have the Ten Commandments of Pleasure?
Yeah. Well, no. But
you got to get the book, darling.
I'm gonna get it.
You got to get the book, the
copy.
Ten Commandments of Pleasure, because the 8th commandment of a gentleman's pleasure is, thou shalt remember what thy mama said. All men are little boys, and boys like toys, and toys, sex toys, can be used to enhance a couple's relationship, where it's a beautiful thing.
Right.
And many couples will do phone sex together like you offered, and or play with sex toys together, watch videos together, or even, and this is not for every couple, but, you know, maybe have a threesome or something,
right,
if they want to get involved with someone else.
Yeah.
But this man is cheating on you. And
yeah.
All men are little boys does not mean boys will be boys. There is no excuse for bad behavior.
Right.
This boy... It apparently has a very difficult time, to use an overused therapeutic phrase, with intimacy.
Right.
And you sound like an open young lady. After all, you have been listening to my show,
right,
I guess, and following along here. And you do exactly what I said, which is, when you find out that he is very involved with some kind of virtual reality sex, whether it's phone sex or computer sex or video sex, you don't act like a mother and reprimand him,
right,
for being, you know, naughty.
Because I'm labeling him, aren't I? I mean,
well, you haven't done that. You didn't do that. You said, why can't we do this together?
Right.
I can be your playmate.
Right.
I can enjoy this with you. I can have phone sex with you. It sounds like that's what you did. You didn't reprimand him and say,
no,
you're a dirty,
the
you know, no
time,
good Nick.
The second time that it happened, I just basically said, I actually left a message on his mailbox. I know.
And she's got a sense of humor about it. Yeah, go, you go, girl.
Boy, you're attached. Well, people attached don't do that to people. You know, it's over. But, and it's tough because I still care about him, but, I mean, he's in denial. He hides things. And that's my concern, is, like, I wouldn't want anybody else in this world to go with this lack of trust, because it's so important in a relationship.
Well, let me ask you this before we go on.
Mm-hmm.
You say you care about him.
Oh, absolutely.
Why?
Because he's a good person.
No, he's not.
Well, see, this is where I need to probably do a little soul searching myself.
And I, you know me, I'm a major phone sex advocate.
Yeah, I guess I deserve better. That's probably it.
Well, I would hope so, honey.
Yeah.
I mean, this is, you know, this is not like a, like if a violence or something, but
right.
this is cheating, this is lying, this is sneaking. You know, it's a drag.
And
you've confronted him about it. You've tried to work it out with him. So if he had a bad experience with a past girlfriend who didn't want to get into, you know, kinky sex or his fantasies or whatever, and he was sneaking because he thought you would be the same way, then maybe you could forgive him for doing it once.
Right.
But he's doing it again and again and again.
So it is destructive.
So you say that he's a good person. I don't think he is. What else? Why else do you care about
him? I was going to say, he looked me in the face the other day and he said to me, I did nothing wrong. And I just thought, you're crazy. I mean, it just...
He did nothing wrong if you guys are not in a relationship.
Yeah,
let's put it that way.
Yeah, I think we're both like very totally separate entities. You know?
Ah, okay, so he doesn't think you're in a relationship.
Maybe not. Well, his voicemail message...
Except his voicemail message...
It said it was attached.
Yeah. So has he done this before in the past?
The phone sex happened in February.
Yeah.
And like I said, it was just phone sex, but never initiating interactions with other women, and he's initiating them, and they're calling, you know.
So. I'm not hearing why you should stay with this guy. He requires a lot of work.
Yes.
And, you know, I mean, I think all relationships require some work.
You know, it's probably just wanting to be with someone, which is a totally lame excuse.
Well, it's natural, darling.
Yeah.
And you've gotten attached to him for some reason. Maybe you're physically attracted to him.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you are.
Yeah.
And maybe is this a pattern in your life? Have you been with guys like this before that have cheated on you in some way?
Not necessarily cheated, but just manipulated, I think.
Well, you got to look at that.
Yeah. This is definitely, like I said,
you got to find a guy that's good to you, because you have a lot to offer. It sounds to me like you do. You know.
Yeah, I just got to do it for me. You know, and that's the tough thing. So.
I mean, listen, if you had kids with this guy, if you were totally, you know, if you'd been with this guy for 10 years and this had just happened and, there was all kinds of other factors, I'd try to work it out with you.
Right.
But it doesn't sound like it's worth it.
Right.
And he doesn't think he's in a real relationship with you. He's just playing a game. He's playing the naughty boy game. You know anything about his mom?
What's that?
What, you know anything about his relationship with mama?
Well, it's not very close, apparently, but... spoken to his sister, and his sister says, I don't know why he turned out this way. He's very self-serving also. It's sort of hedonistic in that just taking pleasure in...
I believe in hedonism, but, darling, I believe in ethical hedonism, finding and cultivating the pleasures in life and not hurting anybody, including yourself, and he is hurting you.
Right.
And you're hurting you by staying in this.
I know.
You're not being ethical to yourself.
Right. No, you're absolutely right. Yeah, every day I get stronger. Every day I get stronger, and I'm moving on.
Well, move out.
Yeah, I am, actually.
Okay.
So, well, thanks so much.
Well, my pleasure.
You're a sweetheart.
You take care.
Bye-bye.
Lisa, and keep me informed. I want to know that you're out of there.
I shall.
Okay.
Thanks.
And on to somebody else who can appreciate a fun sexual playmate
like
you are.
That's right.
All right, Lisa.
Thank you.
How old are you, darling?
I'll be 27 next month.
Oh, you're just getting into your prime.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Find yourself a good one. One you
gonna.
Can share
I'll
the pleasures
back.
Of life. All right, take care.
Bye-bye.
This is the Dr. Susan Block Show.